टुडे प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर मनोज कुमार विल डिस्कस द साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी एफर्ट्स इन इंडिया ऑन द कोविड 19. व्हाट आर द एफर्ट्स ऑफ द साइंस टेक्नोलॉजी एंड द डिफरेंट डिपार्टमेंट ऑन द कोविड 19. दिस इशू इज पब्लिश्ड बाय द विज्ञान प्रासर Department of Science Technology, Government of India, on the 18th April 2020. This is the letter from the Junior Minister of the Health and Welfare, Science and Technology, or Sciences, Government of India. The 2019 Novel coronavirus has spread rapidly throughout the world and assumed the proportion of the pandemic. Given the lack of an efficacious vaccine as well as inability of the suitable chemotherapeutic intervention, mankind is experiencing an unprecedented existential crisis. The Ministry of Science and Technology and Ministry of Health and Welfare with their various departments are contributing in the various ways towards the national R&D efforts for developing solutions to the combat COVID-19. The Department of Science and Technology under the Ministry has launched a nationwide exercise to map and boost development of the COVID-19 solution with R&D, seed capital and the scale-up support. All academic and research institutions are being reoriented to focus on the development of the diagnostic vaccines, antivirals, disease models, and other R&D to enable to cure for this dreadful disease. Around 15 labs of the Council of the Scientific Industrial Research, CSIR, under the development of the scientific and industrial research across the country are working in the close partnership with the major private sector industry, PSU, MSME, and other government department to develop solution for the COVID-19. The Department of the Biotechnology, DBT, under the Ministry has also formed a consortium support to develop the medical equipment, diagnostic, therapy, drug, and vaccine to meet the healthcare challenge. Indian Council of the Medical Research under the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare has already isolated the virus strain successfully, which is a first step toward the vaccine research. Similarly, various other organizations under the Ministry of the Human Resource Development, Ministry of Defense, Ministry of Chemical and Fertilizer, etc. are also contributing substantially to our R&D efforts. The previous sector has also come forward in a big way to supplement these efforts with a view to spreading awareness about the S&T efforts to the government of India as well as a private sector in the funding solution for the COVID-19. Vigyan Prasar, an autonomous institution under the Ministry of the Science and Technology and engaged in the large-scale science communication and the popularization activity, has compiled an initiative being undertaken in this field. This document, Science and Technology Efforts and COVID-19 in India, shall serve as a ready reckoner for the policymaker, scientists, researchers, scholars, and other stakeholders who might be interested in understanding and keeping themselves abreast with the latest S&T supports being made to develop solutions to the combat COVID-19. Preface. At the fag end of the 2019, China informed the World Health Organization regarding the occurrence of the cases of the pandemic of an unknown cause in the Wuhan city in the Hubei province. On January 9, 2000, WHO issued a statement saying Chinese researchers have made the preliminary determination of the virus of a novel coronavirus. Since then, several lakhs of the positive cases and more than 1 lakh deaths have been reported due to COVID-19 across the world. Lockdown, curfews, sealing of the hotspots of the outbreak area, massive airport screening, quarantines, and the social distancing have become the norm across the globe. In these critical times, access to the authentic information is of the paramount importance. Vigyan Parasar has been covering the pandemic since the early days with the science communication perspective and the journalistic flavor, ensuring that science and safety are the primary focus. Vigyan Parasar is a national level organization of the development of the science and technology. Government of India engaged in science communication and the popularization. The principal objective of the Vigyan Parasar is to serve India's science popularization agenda. This is achieved through the several strategically important two-way stakeholder specific approaches to communicate about principles and the practices of the science technology and implication for development and quality of life. Since popularization therefore serves as a robust knowledge-led tool to fulfill various mutually reinforcing public policy objectives. For the benefit of the stockholders, we have prepared a compilation of the most relevant initiative and efforts taken by the Government of India through the various science ministry, department, and funding organizations. These organizations are geared for combating the epidemic of the COVID-19. These research-driven and the technology-based interventions have been initiating on war footing to fight out the outburst of the pandemic. Government of India, through its various wings like the Science Ministry, Department, and Funding of Organization, has invited calls for the proposal and expression of interest to enhance research and development-related activity to battle the pandemic out. We hope this initiative of the Vigyan Parasar shall be a handy guide to the scientists, researcher, and scholar, especially those who are interested in knowing the various aspects of the COVID-19 and contributing to the coronavirus warfare in whatever muscle and the people at large. Vigyan Parasar, New Delhi. Dr. Harshvardhan exhort CSIR scientists to develop COVID-19 mitigation solution to effectively combat the disease. 12th April 2020, New Delhi. Genetic sequencing has crucial in inverting polio. It will help in the COVID-19 mitigation, also said Dr. Harshvardhan. There are times of the war, deliver solution before war ends, not a routine search project, said the Dr. Harshvardhan. COVID-19 will give boost to country's resilience and self-reliance and enhance industry capacity in developing critical health care equipment. Today, Dr. Harshvardhan, Union Minister for the Science and Technology, held a review with the DG, CSIR, Dr. Shekhar C. Munde, and all the CSIR lab director through the video conference of the step taken by the CSR and its constituent 30 labs toward the mitigation of the coronavirus outbreak in the country. DG CSIR, Dr. Shekhar C. Munde, informed the core strategy group has been set up in the CSIR and the five verticals have been identified under which the COVID-19 related activity being carried out. These include digital and molecular surveillance, rapid economical diagnostic, new drug repurging of the drugs and associated production process, hospital assistive devices, PPE and supply chain, and the logistic support. System Dr. Munde also mentioned that the 15 CSIR labs are working in close partnership with the major industry, PSU, MSME, and other department and ministry at the time of the crisis in the country. After briefing of all the efforts being made by the CSIR lab in finding a solution for the COVID-19, Dr. Harshvardhan informed them about the steps being taken by the Government of India in the combating COVID-19. Dr. Harshvardhan exhorted CSR scientists and said India has high expectation from its scientific community, and I am sure that the community will rise to the occasion and deliver in this time of the need. He appreciated that the CSR lab were also participating in the testing of the swab sample of the COVID patient, and some of them have started doing genetic sequencing of the virus with a target of doing 500 sequencing of the coming back. Dr. Harshvardhan said genetic sequencing is very crucial in identifying the host response as well as identifying population vulnerability to the disease. He said the generic sequencing efforts remind me of the polio eradication movement 20 years back. Towards the fag end of the polio movement, active surveillance of the country was done to find out the cases of the acute phallocyte paralysis. That time also, genetic sequencing has used to establish the travel history of the polio virus, which eventually helped in the eradication of the polio. He also appreciated CSIR for partnering with the MSME major industry, PSU, working on the RT-PCR machine. He said plasma-based therapy is very much needed at this hour. For this, we need to motivate the patient who have recovered from the COVID-19 to donate blood. He also appreciated the work done by the CSR NAIL with the BHL bail on ventilators, oxygen enrichment devices, and 3D printed face shield, face mask, gown, and other protective equipment. All these things will help in the next few weeks, he said. Dr. Harshvardhan, however, cautioned CSR scientists to develop COVID-19 mitigation solution, keeping fixed time frame in the mind. These are the times of the war. CSR scientists should work to deliver solution before the war ends. They should not treat it as a routine research project. He said COVID-19 has also come as a blessing, as a disgust, as it will give boost to the country's resilience and the self-reliance and enhance indigenous capacity in developing critical healthcare equipment. He also appreciated the collaboration being done by the CSR scientists using the video conferencing tool, and reiterated the scientists that while doing research, they should continue observing social distancing and lockdown because till such time vaccine is developed by the scientists to combat COVID-19. These two remain the most potent form of the social vaccine. Dr. Shekhar C. Menda, DG CSR, Dr. Anurag Agrawal, Director Institute of the Genomics and the Interactive Biology, and Dr. Nakul Parasar, Director Vigyan Parasar, were present in the review meeting with the Union Minister, Director of the remaining 38 CSIR lab, attended the meeting through video conference. Chitra Genome Lamp and makes conformity test result of the COVID-19 possible in 2 hours. Sri Chitra Trinol Institute of Medical Science and Technology, Trivandrum, an institute of national importance of the Department of Science Technology, have developed a diagnostic test kit that can confirm COVID-19 in 2 hours at low cost. The conformity diagnostic test, which detects N gene of the SARS-CoV-2 using the reverse transcript loop mediated amplification of the viral nucleic acid, will be one of the world's first few, if not the first of its kind in the world. The test kit funded by the DST called the Chitra Geni Lampen is highly specific for the SARS-CoV-2 engine and can detect two regions of the gene, which will ensure that the test does not fail if one region of the viral gene undergoes mutation during its current spread. The test performed at the NIV Alphaja show that the Chitra Geni Lampen has 100% accuracy and match with the test result using RT-PCR. This has been initiated to the ICMR, the authority to approve it for the COVID-19 testing in India, following which license need to be obtained from the CDSO for manufacturing. Current PCR kits in India enable detection of the E gene for the screen and RDRP-GEN for confirmation. Chitra, GeniLamp and gene testing will allow confirmation in one test without the need for screening test and at much lower cost. The detection time is the 10 minutes and sample to real time from the RNA extraction is the swarm to the RT-LAMP detection time will be less than 2 hours. A total of the 30 samples can be tested in a single batch, in a single machine, allowing a large number of samples to be tested each day. Development of novel, inexpensive and rapid conformity for the diagnosis of the COVID-19 by the C. Chitra in record time is a compelling example of how creative team of the clinician has scientists working together seamlessly can leverage knowledge and infrastructure to make the relevant breakthrough. Establishment of technology research center at the 4 other DST institutions has brought rich dividend by the conservation of the basic research into the important technology, said Professor Ashutosh Sharma, Secretary, DST. The testing facility can be easily set up in the laboratory of the district hospital with limited facility and the trained laboratory technician. The result can be read from the machine from the change in the fluorescence. The cost with the new device for lamp testing and the test kit for the two region of the engine, including RNA extraction, will be less than ₹1,000 per test of the laboratory. Sri Chitra has also additionally developed the specific RNA extraction kits along with the GeniLamp test kit and testing devices. The technology was transferred for manufacture to the M-Expert Dynamics Ernakulam, a leading company in the Vitro diagnostic with the national and the international operation. Dr. Anup Terkoli, a senior scientist of the biomedical technology wing of the institute and scientist in charge of the division of the molecular medicine under the Department of the Applied Biology, and his team developed the kit in the last 3 weeks. For more details, contact this one. Please contact this one. PRO, Samstri, mobile number is given, email is given. Website is given. Index science technology efforts by the Office of the Principal Scientific Advisor. Science technology efforts by the Department of the Science and Technology. Science technology efforts by the Department of the Biotechnology. Science technology effort by the Council of the Scientific and Industrial Research. Science technology effort by the Indian Council of the Medical Research, Ministry of Health and the Welfare. Science technology effort by the Defense Research and Development Organization, DRDO. Science technology effort by Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology, MIT. Science technology effort by the other scientific and academic institutions. Science technology effort by the private sector enterprises. Science technology effort to deal with the COVID-19 by the Office of the Principal Scientific Advisor, PSA. Extending testing facility in the country, the empowered committee on the R&D has worked towards the enhancing the testing facility to meet the COVID-19 related challenges by leveraging the existing resources, instrument and the human resource in Government of India. Laboratory, it has enabled ICMR to issue the required notification allowing institution under DST, DVT, CSIR, DA, DRDO and Indian Institute of Science to self-assess and prepare their BCL labs for research and testing coronavirus. The PSA has developed handbook of the COVID-19 testing in the research institution, which allows more such lab to self-assess its preparedness in terms of the equipment, staff and expertise required for the COVID-19 testing. A detailed checklist has been outlined, which can be used by research lab to self-assess and indicate their preparedness for declaring the lab as a research of testing of the COVID-19 after ICMR approval. This handbook has been assembled by a group of the young researchers whose efforts are gratefully acknowledged. Novel Coronavirus Disease 2009 COVID-19 guidelines on the rational use of the personal protective equipment. The guideline is for the healthcare workers and the work other working in the point of entry, quadrant central, hospital, laboratory, and the primary healthcare community settings. The guidelines uses the setting approach to guide on the type of the personal protective equipment to be used in the different setting. Foot operated washing station implemented at IU. Foot operated washing station implemented at the Indian Astronomical Observatory. Hane Ladakh provided an example for the implementation in the guideline for the hygiene and sanitation in densely populated area during the COVID-19 pandemic released by the office of the PSO. IU has one of the world's highest located sites for the optical, infrared and gamma ray telescope. It is operated by the Indian Institute of Astrophysics, Bangalore. Science technology effort on COVID-19 by the Department of the Science and Technology. Interview of the DST Secretary, Professor Ashutosh Sharma. Big DSI development on a rapid test for the COVID-19 has been discovered by the Trivandrum-based government lab. They have developed a new conformity diagnostic test for the coronavirus that gives result in the minutes. Once scaled up, this will lessen the burden of the importing test kit. In a special interview with Pallav Bagla, Professor Ashutosh Sharma, Secretary of Department of Science Technology, talked about this very important development. RBI scientists explain the relevance of the mathematical model. Scientists of the Raman Research Institute and Autonomous Institute of the Department of Science Technology has analyzed the importance of the mathematical models that are being issued by the scientists for the prediction of the COVID-19 pandemic, for planning future action, and the relevance of these models for the common public. RI scientist Joseph Samuel and Suparna Sinha has reached out to the common people and explained the relevance of the mathematical model in decision making for the citizens and policymaker who may not be from the scientific background. They have addressed the key questions like what one can learn from those models, how seriously they should be taken, why the predictors from the different models may differ, how these models are constructed. The article seeks to remove the confusion that may be prevailing about the mathematical model due to the varied prediction they make. It also illustrates how models have been used by the many countries in taking decisions. The scientists have explained that simple models can capture qualitative features as well as make predictions based on the value of the new parameter, for instance, doubling time, which can be gleaned from the past data as the models get more complicated and realistic. The number of parameters also increases. This results in a new kind of uncertainty stemming from the ignorance of large number of the parameters. The small changes of the parameter can lead to the large changes in the outcome for a period of the time. For more details, contact this one, mobile number, this one. Indian industry respond enthusiastically to the TDB invitation for the proposal of the fighting COVID-19. The Indian industry and the startup ecosystem have responded in kindly to the invitation by the Technology Department Board, a statutory body of the Department of Science Technology, for proposal from the Indian company and enterprises for supporting technology innovative solution toward fighting COVID-19. TDP provides financial support to the Indian company for the commercialization of the indigenous technology or adoption of the imported technology, and had invited proposal on the March 20, 2020, to strengthen the nation's core capacity in fighting COVID-19. It covers key areas like the surveillance, laboratory support, infection prevention and control, logistic risk communication, and in particular to strengthen the capability in terms of the isolation and management of the critically ill patient for containing the and preventing the spread of the pandemic. Summer COVID-19 hackathon under the National Super Computing Mission. Center of the Development of the Advanced Computing, CDEC, under the aegis of the National Super Computing Mission, a missionary ministry of the Electronics and Information Technology and Department and Science Technology Initiative in association with the NIFTA, announces the COVID-19 hackathon. integrated geospatial platform to help area-specific strategy and decision in the COVID-19 outbreak. The Department of Science and Technology, Government of India, has created an integrated geospatial platform out of the available geospatial data set, standard-based services, and analytical tool to help decision-making during the current COVID-19 outbreak. Eight, devising the Asia-specific strategy to handle socioeconomic impact in the recovery phase. The platform is initially expected to strengthen the public health delivery system of the state and central government and subsequently provide the necessary geospatial information support to citizen and agency dealing with the challenges related to the health, socioeconomic distress, and the livelihood challenges. The mobile application Sahyog, as well as the web portal prepared and managed by the Survey of India, has been customized to collect COVID-19 special geospatial data sets through the community management to the argument and the response activity of Government India to the pandemic information parameter requirement as Government of India strategy. The mobile application will complement Arogya Setu mobile application launched by the Government of India for contact tracing, public awareness, and self-assessment objectives. State official data infrastructure in Madhya Pradesh, Odisha, Punjab, Jammu Kashmir have been providing collateral standard-based geospatial services to the state district level authority in respective states through the state geo portal for integration with the related health data sets combating COVID-19 pandemic. A special call under the SATM to fight Stagandang COVID-19. Department of Science Technology invited concept under the science technology of yoga medicine for the appropriate intervention of the yoga medicine to fight against COVID-19 and other similar kind of the virus. This special call aimed to provide assistance to our society in today's critical condition arising due to the pandemic COVID-19. The project may address on improving immunity, improving respiratory system, stress, anxiety, depression, and other. Call for expression of the instead second set of the product. Sri Chitra Tribunal Institute of the Medical Science Technology, Trivandrum, and Institute of National Importance under the Department of Science Technology has developed designs and know-how for the several products to combat the COVID-19 pandemic crisis. The institute is interested in transferring these designs and know-how to entry that can manufacture and make them available to the users. Expression of interest is invited from the interested entry for this purpose. Expression of interest for developing and manufacturing devices for the fast track program of the COVID-19 pandemic. Sri Chitra Tribunal Institute for the Medical Science and Technology, Trivandrum, invites manufacturer, startup, social group who are interested in working with the institute to co-develop and manufacture medical devices on a fast-track mode to support the distressing situation created by the epidemic COVID-19. The call is for the development of the Ambu bag-based ventilator, ventilator sharing kit, battery-operated assisting breathing unit, isolation pods, disposable safety face shield, and deploy field units. Proposal invited on COVID-19 and related respiratory viral infection. Science and Engineering Research Board, a statutory body of the Department of Science Technology, invites proposal as part of the special call under the IERSPA scheme designed especially for the COVID-19 and related respiratory viral infection to revamp up national R&D efforts for the new antiviral vaccine and affordable diagnostics. Call for proposal Indo-US virtual network for the COVID-19. The Indus-US Science Technology Forum announces a call for the proposal for the COVID-19 Indo-US virtual network, encourages the COVID